Lent, Week 5, Thursday. A reading from the Constitution of the Second Vatican Council on the Church. The Church, the visible sacrament of saving unity. Behold, the days are coming, says the Lord, when I will make a new covenant with the house of Israel and the house of Judah. I will put my law within them, and I will write it upon their hearts. I will be their God, and they shall be my people. For they shall all know me, from the least of them even to the greatest, says the Lord. Christ instituted this new covenant, that is to say, the New Testament, in His blood, by calling together a people made up of Jew and Gentile, making them one, not according to the flesh, but the Spirit. This was to be the new people of God. For those who believe in Christ, who are reborn, not from a perishable, but from an imperishable seed, through the word of the living God, not from flesh, but from water and the Holy Spirit, are finally established as a chosen race, a royal priesthood, a holy nation, a purchased people, who in times past were not a people, but are now the people of God. That messianic people has Christ as its head, who was delivered up for our sins and rose again for our justification. And now, having won a name which is above all names, reigns in glory in heaven. The heritage of this people is the dignity and freedom of the sons of God, in whose hearts the Holy Spirit dwells as in His temple. Its law is the new commandment to love as Christ loved us. Its destiny is the kingdom of God, which was begun by God Himself on earth, and which is to be further extended until it is brought to perfection by Him at the end of time. Then Christ, our life, will appear, and creation itself also will be delivered from its slavery to corruption into the freedom of the glory of the sons of God. So it is that this messianic people, though it does not actually include all men, and may at times look like a small flock, is nonetheless a lasting and sure seed of unity, hope, and salvation for the whole human race. Established by Christ as a communion of life, love, and truth, it is also used by Him as an instrument for the redemption of all, and as the light of the world and the salt of the earth is sent forth into the whole world. Just as Israel, according to the flesh, wandering as an exile in the desert, was already called the Church of God, so the new Israel, going forward in the present world, seeking a future and abiding city, is also called the Church of Christ. Indeed, He has purchased it for Himself with His blood, has filled it with His Spirit, and provided it with means suitable for its visible and social unity. God has called together as one all who in faith look upon Jesus as the author of salvation and the source of unity and peace. He has established them as the Church, so that for each and all she may be the visible sacrament of this saving unity.